Lift your hand and say, my last meal shall be my miracle. Hallelujah. When the widow of Zarephath meet Elijah, she thought she was preparing her last meal. Am I right? But a simple act of faith, a simple act of faith, hallelujah, produce a miracle for this woman. She trusted Elijah and gave all she had to him to eat. You didn't hear what I just said? That's a problem with a lot of people. Real prophets, they don't trust, but false prophet. All right. She did not know him, but the Bible said God prepared her to feed him. So when he arrived for food, mighty God, he asked for the food, but to his surprise, the woman who God sent him to is a widow. Number one, that means she don't have no man or minor, she don't have no husband, and she don't have no rich man to give her care, house and land. Because some of you women feel like you can't trust God for a miracle. You need man for everything. And you must learn to be independent and trust God sometime. Because some of them man, just because them know you have a need, they become users and abusers. Just because them know you depend upon them for everything. You know what I preach? Man feel like you can't live if you don't have a man around you. But I true, because some of you lazy like wow. You want to just want to act up and dress up in a long hair and long nails and short Kentucky clothes. And but all the ladies who work hard for your money, praise God. Glory to God. She was a widow. She had a son. She had her last meal. There was a famine going on. She doesn't have an income. And something may line up for some of you, you know. But a miracle will come for work. And you have to know that when you're at your lowest and you think you're at your worst, is when God will come true to deliver you. When you think it's over, God is just getting ready to give you a new start, a fresh start. I feel the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You would have thought that God would have sent this prophet to somebody who had house, land, money, care, everything to take care of him. But he sent the prophet to a woman who had absolutely nothing. She was so at a place of giving up that she declared it out of her own mouth. I'm gonna eat, we're gonna eat the last meal and die. But I come to tell somebody in this fasting experience today that you shall not die. Like talking to someone, I don't care what your situation is. I don't care if a dead angel is at your gate. I don't care if famine, poverty, or science working against you today. I come to declare from a prophetic mouth, Mark Stewart, the prophet of God, come to tell you, I don't care who threaten you. I don't care what situation threaten you. I come to tell you, you shall not die. Lift your hand and say, it's not over. Everything around me look dead. Every situation look dying. But God is about to resurrect you even before you die, even before you give up. God is about to send a prophetic anointed angel into your situation. I hear God say to tell you, I know that what you have is the last you have. But God said to tell you, your last meal shall become your miracle. Somebody praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. A widow. Listen. She trusted Elijah and gave all she had to him to heed. Faith is the step between promise and assurance. Miracle seems as out of reach for our feeble faith. Some of you think miracle is out of your reach. Lift your hand and say, no miracle is out of my reach. Hallelujah. Every miracle, large or small, begin with an act of obedience. A lot of people in the church of God do not act according to obedience. Many people act the way they feel. The way they think. It's not the way you feel. It's not the way you think. It is what God requires. God says, I have provided a widow, a woman to feed you. So when he went to the woman, he said, feed me, because God said to tell you, after you feed me, your basket, your flour, your oil will never run out at all. Not just that God prepared her, but God sent the prophet to test her to see if she would release that which God wanted her to release in order for her to get the breakthrough. Some of you are living below the poverty line because that which God asked you for, you thought it was too much to give him. But what God had to give you is much more than you can ever ask or imagine. God is about to bless you beyond measures. Somebody get ready for a supernatural miracle today. God is about to turn your scars into stars. God is about to send back your dead angel. Somebody now say nothing to me. Somebody say, reverse every dead angel coming from my life. God said to tell you, I'm gonna reverse it. If it's accident, I'm gonna reverse it. If it's sickness, I'm gonna reverse it. If it's obia, I'm going to I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the Holy Ghost. Lift your faith and trust God is able to do. He prepared the widow. He sent the prophet. And he said, prophet, when you go, ask her for what she got so I can supply all her needs according to my riches in glory. But I remember a young man had 7 cases at court. I was in Montego Bay preaching. When he was leaving his house and went out, he says, mommy, something told me to carry $5,000. The mama said, go in back and get it and carry it. When he came to church at the fasting service that day, I said, somebody here need to sow $5,000 right now. He said, mommy, here, pastor. He said, then no, you carry, go on. He brought the $5,000 because the Lord prepared him to bring $5,000. Then the Lord told me to ask for $5,000. When he gave it and I prayed, he went to court the evening in Montego Bay, St. James. He sat in the courthouse waiting for his name to call for 7 offense, traffic tickets and all heap of thing, all evening till the last name was called. He never heard his name. He went to the clerk of court and he said, clerk of court, I am here to answer charge to 7 cases. I wonder how much you have. How much you have? How much case you have? The last seed shall work a miracle. The clerk of court said, what's your name? He told her. She searched the book and said, man, you waste your time. Your name is not in my book. You still don't tell me how much you have. Huh? One? Let me preach this. Somebody praise God. Somebody say miracle. Somebody holla miracle. Hallelujah. Elijah said to the woman, but make me a cake first, give him glory, then use what you have left to prepare yourself and your son, for this is what the Lord said. Hold on, watch this. When she prepared the cake, she should not have none left. I said, when she baked the cake and put it in the oven, the sun will wash up and wash out the pan because there is nothing left. But watch the prophetic word. The man of God said, after you bake me a cake, then go and prepare for you and your son, because the Lord said, the Lord says, oh. Holy Ghost. This is serious business. Hallelujah. Use what you have left. Use what you have left. Remember, what she had was to prepare one cake. But the prophet is prophesying to her. After you bake me one cake, use what you have left to bake another cake for you and your son. For the Lord says, somebody ain't getting ready for a miracle. There will always be flour and oil left in your container. Touch your neighbor, say, you're not gonna wash it. You're not gonna get free wash it. You're not gonna get free turn it on. You're not gonna get free score it out. Because the more you pour out, is the more is coming in. The more you release is the more you're going to receive. Somebody praise God. Somebody lift up your handbag. Lift up your purse. Lift up your wallet. Lift up something. Say, in the name of Jesus, pour it in. Send more, God. Full up my bag. Full up my purse. Pack up my wallet. Lord, 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 Lord. No. This is what the Lord says. Watch the prophecy. After you give me the cake, when you empty that pan, that oil jar and bucket, you will be able to still prepare a cake for you and your son. Because the Lord said to tell you, you will never be out of flour and oil in your container until the time when the Lord seed rain, send rain and crops to grow for your blessing. Somebody, you will never run out. Somebody say, never run out. Somebody say, until God send rain, I'll never run out. I always will be blessed. Lift your hands, lift your purse, lift your wallet. Say, never run out. I'll have money. I'll have riches. I will be blessed. Food on my table, things in my fridge. My fridge shall be full. My cupboard never empty. My house, my family, my blessing will never run out. I shall never, my last seed shall be my miracle. Hallelujah. Somebody get ready. The prophet said to tell you, God said to tell you, get ready for a miracle. Today is your day for a new beginning. You shall not die, but live. You will never, somebody said, never run out. Say, I shall never run out. My bank account will never run out. My cupboard, my fridge, my handbag, somebody handbag will all money. You don't have to sell yourself. You don't have to use your body. It will never, never, never. How many of you believe it? How many of you believe it? I want to tell you, somebody over here, the house that you want to purchase, the house you're going after, the house is secure. The house is secure. You will never run out. You shall have it. It's yours. Somebody give him the glory. I feel the Holy Ghost. It's over. It's over. God said, I tell you, no more poverty. I hear the Holy Ghost said to tell 10 women in this business building who is waiting for marriage and your widow days is over. I hear God said, I tell you, it's going to happen. You will never be single no more. I'm gonna tell somebody over here, because somebody over there don't want it. You've been proposed to be married for long, and it cannot happen. God said, I tell you, you will never be single no longer. Your widow days is over. Your one pot meal is over. Get ready to cook a lot of food, because company is coming in the house. Company is coming in your house. God is up. Somebody say miracle. Miracle. A prophet is about to locate you, because God sent me to tell you it's going to happen. Forget about death. Touch your neighbor, say, forget about death. Forget about death. The death angel cannot stop at your door anytime soon. The only thing you're getting is a husband, a wife, and a lot of spending money with a lot of food. Who wants it? Some of you ladies are not honest with yourself. You're behaving as if I'm not preaching to you. She was a widow. Preacher, watch how I'm going to mash up some people. Why did you say that to us women? What are you trying to do? Let me tell you what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get to something, sir. Are you ready for a divine revelation? The man of God, when he went into the house to eat the last meal, he said, by the way, do you have a room to put me up, because I'm not leaving here anytime soon. I come to live with you. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, it's not a stop by. It's not a stop by visit. Somebody's coming to live with you. Blessing is about to live with you. Breakthrough is about to live with you. Miracle is about to live with you. one you feed will not live.
Holy Ghost,
take time with me now. The next man, or the man you have that you've been feeding, or he never ate from you, the first and last meal that you give him is gonna cause him to marry you. Hold on. Don't cook no stew peas and no curry chicken and put nothing in there from Obia man. It ain't gonna work. Make sure it is a prophetic release. Listen, Elijah never told her he was coming to live. He said, woman, I'm thirsty and hungry. Give me water and cake. After she fed him, she realized he's not going nowhere. Why? Because God prepared her to feed him. Not only did she get food, not only did she get life, but she now has a man who is a provider in the house. I never said they had a relationship, but they had a fellowship. She was a widow who needed a man in the house. But to get a man in the house, she had to do what God wanted her to do, to get a man in the house to provide and protect her life. You need a man first to come and trick you. You need God first to direct you. I feel like talking to a woman. I said, you don't need to sell your life to a man first, thinking you need that. You need to hear what God is saying. Because God is saying, if you give me what I need from you, then I will supply all your needs according to my riches in glory. I will bless you. And if anybody curse you, I will curse them. And I will bless them that bless you. The man of God was in the house. And as long as the man of God was in the house, he wanted food. And if the man of God wanted food, then God has to supply food to the woman to keep on baking. Lift your hands up. Say, I'm gonna keep on baking. I'm gonna keep on baking. Touch your neighbor, say, excuse me, I don't know if you're a baker, but all when me can bake, I'm ready to bake and make a cake. Are you ready to bake your cake? Your last meal shall be your miracle. Your last meal shall be your miracle. Release it. You don't have nothing. And the little you have is not enough. But I hear God say, give me. Because I realize you're running out. And I realize if you run out today, you're expecting to die tomorrow. Amen. You see why I'm not just I'm a preacher. Deliver. I'm built for this. You got to live your faith. You see why if Reverend Mark Stewart, if you believe I'm a prophet, and if I says to you when you come into my church, well, not my church, God's church, I was reminded, it's not mine, it's for God, but I run it for God. If I tell you, help me run it with your seed, help me. Because when you give to the house, you will always get from. Why? Because as long as the prophet is in the house, you can never be hungry. Because God organized it for the prophet to be fed. And as long as the prophet is fed, you will be fed too. I hear God say, somebody, God will use you to bless somebody in order for you to receive all the miracles you're waiting for. How many know God is like that? You are it. I worship you. I worship you. Hey, yeah. Waymaker, miracle work, the promise, the light in the dark. Waymaker, Lord, the miracle work, the promise. Listen, are you ready for it? Are you ready for it? Miracle. Anything that seems impossible today will become possible. Anything that you are about to give up on, you can forget about giving up on it. Hallelujah. Put on your water. Drink, put it down, lift your hands. Take as much, drink a good drink. Put it down, lift your hands. Miracle worker. Light. That is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, the promise, the light in the. That is who you are. Get ready, get ready. This is what the Lord says. There will always be flour and oil. Blessing and breakthrough in your jar. Your container will not be empty until the famine is over. Lift your hands. Makoli Boshata. We're going to do 7 shouts. Deliverance is coming to you in this house today. Serious business. Lift your faith. You don't need to look around for nobody. This is your miracle. You have already spoken what you need. Get ready to expect it miraculously today. In the mighty name of Jesus. At the count of one, I wanted to shout, my last meal shall be my miracle. You get that? Are you ready? Open your belly and your mouth. One, shout! At the count of two, I want you to shout, I believe the prophet. One, two, shout! At the count of three, and three is where the debt is. Hallelujah. At this number three, the woman said, I'm gonna eat the last and die. I want you to declare, I reverse debt in Jesus' name. One, two, three, shout! Yes! Reverse every debt trap, every debt angel, every dead situation, every dead thing, I reverse it now by fire, by force. Yes, 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 yes. Reverse. 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 Oh, glory to God. At the count of four, I want you to declare, my container will never be empty. Are you ready? My container will never be empty. One, two, three, four, shout! Will never be empty! Lord God, I feel the Holy Ghost. At the count of five, I want to declare, Lord, bless my house and family. One, two, three, four, five. Lord, bless my house and at the count of six, I want you to agree with God right now. Listen this one box. I will bake the cake and serve it. I didn't say eat it enough. And serve it. Lord, I will bake the cake and serve it. One, two, three, four, five, six. Shout, Lord, I will bake the cake and serve it. Ula baba sata kato la bashata. Get ready for a miracle. Get ready for a miracle. Get ready for a miracle. At the count of seven, get ready for a miracle. I'll serve it. I'll bake the cake and serve it, because when I serve it, my container will never be empty. I feel God. One shout to go. Lift your hand. Lord, fill my life forever with miracles. As of today, miracle starts. And when miracle starts for you, it will not stop anytime soon. Lord, fill my life with miracles forever. Are you ready?